Hello, Doug here. Welcome to Selecting Astrophotography Equipment Part 5, Selecting a Guide Scope. First, let's discuss the purpose of a guide scope and camera. Most telescope mounts, after they are properly aligned, will do a good job of tracking the stars for a few seconds. However, to achieve nice round stars, you need a guide scope. The purpose of a guide scope is to lock on a star and send fine adjustments to your mount. With a guiding system, you'll track the night sky more accurately. With auto guiding, you'll be able to take longer exposures and capture fantastic astro images. As with all astrophotography equipment, there are tons of choices. Basically, there are two categories of guide scopes: a dedicated guide scope or an off-axis guider, also known as an OAG. The OAG style is for advanced users who have time to fiddle with fine adjustments. An OAG takes a tiny part of your optical train and reflects this tiny section to your autoguider. Your imaging camera shares the same optical path as your autoguide camera. The reward of using an OAG is you can use the same scope you use for imaging, and it has the potential to lighten the load of your AP setup. Some people claim an OAG helps reduce flexure. Flexure is when your main scope moves without your guide scope. I'm telling you right now, even under the best conditions, you'll run into some kind of challenge, and the last thing you need to mess around with is your guide scope. Since these videos are designed for the first-time astrophotographer, I'll be discussing the dedicated guide scope. I believe the dedicated guide scope is the easiest and most reliable option for beginners. There seems to be a popular movement towards the 50mm finder scopes for auto guiding. If you already have a 50mm finder scope, you can easily modify it to accept a guide camera. Orion offers the 50mm guide scope package for $350. If you already have a guide camera, Orion sells the 50mm guide scope for $100. Orion also offers an 80mm guide scope package for $400, but stay away from the set screw mounts. Set screw clamps will introduce the dreaded flexure to your imaging train. Instead of using set screws, use solid ring mounting brackets. Solid mounting rings firmly grab your scope and reduces flexure. Don't worry too much about the guide scope. Almost any scope with a 1.25 inch draw tube will work. If you decide to use a guide scope for guiding, grab a refractor. And when you find focus, you can mark the draw tube, so the next time you'll have perfect focus. The Orion Starshoot Autoguider is a great guide scope camera at $280. It's a good entry-level guide camera. The Starshoot Autoguider is a little bit noisy when you compare it to other high-end autoguide cameras. The Starshoot Autoguider has a little problem locking on the guide star and maximum DL. However, using Push Here Dummy, PhD, the Starshoot Autoguider works flawlessly. If you decide to look at high-end auto guide cameras, you'll be looking to spend $600 or more. It's important to support the cables attaching to your auto guider so you don't run into connector problems later down the road. The Starshoot Auto Guider is the best value, and you will enjoy how simple it is to use. With PhD software, it's literally push here, dummy, and away you go. I recommend the Starshoot Auto Guider camera for beginners. An auto guider camera needs to connect to your mount via the auto guider port. Syncing your mount with an auto guider camera will help you take longer exposures. Taking longer exposures is the key to successful imaging, and an auto guider is required for astrophotography. Thanks for watching, and please visit myastroimages.com. Stay tuned for the next video, Selecting Accessories.